Hey everybody, what is up? I'm the MacMage, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you a really awesome app that will help you edit photos that isn't Adobe Photoshop. So stay tuned. So if you've ever used a Windows PC, you'll know about an app called Paintbrush. And this app is pretty much Photoshop light. Like, it doesn't have all the bells and whistles and frills of Adobe Photoshop, but it'll do in a pinch, and it is free. Now, unfortunately, for whatever reason, Mac did not bundle this app within its software, although I think they should have, because it's an essential app, especially if you don't want to spend the money or the time to learn Photoshop. So I use this app all the time for editing things, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to do so, how easy it is to acquire the app, and how easy it is to download it. It's just a really quick file to get, and I'm going to have the direct link in the description. Again, for those of you who've never used a direct link, basically once you click on the link, it's going to start the download. It's virus-free, spam-free, adware-free. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing you guys are going to want to do, I'll go ahead and show you the app first of all. So here I have my MacMage logo, and there are some imperfections that are kind of nagging, so I want to clean them up because I couldn't really do them on my phone very well. So this paint program will be perfect for cleaning them up. So what I'm going to do is go over to my image. I'm going to click on Open With, and then I'm going to open it directly within the Paintbrush app. So when you open this up for the first time, it's going to ask you if you want to update it automatically, and you can choose yes. It's a very small file, and it really doesn't have very many updates. So we're going to go ahead and go over here and check out the menu. It's got pretty basic things that you can do. You can, you know, drop color and erase things. You have different ways of adding color and annotations, texts, things like that. You have the basic sort of edit bar, things that you can do in here. So it's very good for some light editing of photos. And of course you can also change your colors and stuff just like that. So it's very light and easy app to use. And so let me go ahead and show you how to get it. I'll also go ahead and include the indirect download, so that way if you'd like to read up a little bit more about it, you can. Again, this is by no means Adobe Photoshop. It doesn't take much time to learn how to use or anything like that. So if you want to do some more reading, I will leave the indirect download in the description as well. What you're going to do is just click right here on this little link right here to go ahead and begin the downloading process. And I'll go ahead and do that right now. And then you have two versions. You have version 2.1.2 and 2.1.2. Excuse me. You're going to want, of course, the one that is highest. So go ahead and click that. And then you'll be brought here. And then it'll tell you that your download is going to be starting. And then, of course, down in the download area, you are going to see it download. And it's a really quick download. As you can see, it's already done. So once it is complete, just get out of that, and then you'll have this little zip file here. Go ahead and double click it, and then this little paintbrush application thingy is going to be here, and you're going to want to drag it to your applications folder. I have my applications folder here, so you would drag it there, or if you have your applications folder up here, you're going to want to click go, and then of course click on applications. And then you can drag it in that way. So, like that. So, however you choose to do that, wherever your application menu is at, that's all you have to do. And then you can just toss the zip folder in the recycling bin. Now, incidentally, just let me show you a really quick trick. If you want this little applications folder in your dock and you want it like that, simple. All you have to do is click go and click applications, and then up here you're going to see the applications thing, the applications header. See, do you see what I just did? I just clicked this little folder and then pulled it out right here, and then you can just drag it into your dock, and it, up here is where it will show up. So that's all you have to do to get that like that, and that will work for any folder that you want to shortcut into your dock. So once you have that application opened up, or once you have it installed, I should say, then you can just go ahead and begin to use it with your photos. So I have some alterations that I'd like to make to my MacMage logo, as you can see here. So I'm going to go ahead and pause the video now, and I'll return when I've made the alterations. So as you can see, I just wanted to make some alterations to the broom, make it look a little broomier, and then just make some alterations to just, you know, little areas where it just were imperfected. So, and that's pretty much what it's good for, just making small changes to video, to photos. You can add texts and, you know, do some awesome things. And in the text, of course, you can have different fonts, things like that. It's just a really simple little essential app to have if you don't want to take the time or spend the money on Adobe Photoshop. So it's just a quick little tutorial on this really awesome app. Again, links will be in the description, both the indirect link if you want to do some reading about the app, or if you want to just download it straight away, those links will both be in the description. So thanks you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.